Welcome to Abhipedia QChat 2016's Mains Question Answer Discussion. Today we have Mr. Ajay Sondhi with us, who is our core faculty for security issues. And we'll be asking him certain questions upon the J&K scenario, especially because it's too much into limelight right now, especially after the Uri attacks. So, sir, how do you explore the J&K situation first off?
See, J&K problem, it started since independence. And in 90s, it aggravated. So, as of now, we say that Pakistan is fighting a proxy war and cross-border terrorism is a major issue. But if you see the Burhan Wani involvement, that means the local people, the local, young guys are also, waging this war.
Okay.
So, first of all, we are fighting on two fronts,
okay.
Inside and outside.
Okay.
So, as far as the proxy war is concerned, after I 65 war, mm-hmm. When Pakistan lost, the premier, he went to China, and Chinese premier told him frankly that you cannot win a direct war with India.
Okay.
So better you start a proxy war.
Okay.
So as far as my knowledge is concerned, that Pakistan, China is using Pakistan against India, and we have to also win over the local public opinion.
Okay.
And after the Uri attack, the whole equation has changed.
Okay.
Though we have conducted some surgical strikes, across the border.
Okay.
But that has been politicized,
Okay.
And the final aim and objective has not been properly encashed.
Mm-hmm. Sir, then why is it that Pakistan is refusing to accept line of control as the de facto border? Why is it that the Pakistani political dispensation says that no, we want the whole of Kashmir? Jabki Kashmir, they have one third of the Kashmir. क्या ये India की shortcoming in its foreign policy approach? या is it that Pakistan is a theocratic state and run by army institute security?
बाजपेयी साहब ने एक बार बोला था कि we cannot change neighbors, we can change friends and enemies, we cannot change neighbors. So we have a notorious neighbor. It is universally, everybody is supporting India internationally.
Yes.
So we have to devise a proper strategy in order to curtail Pakistan, because they are also fighting a war in Pakistan.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as your question is concerned, Pakistan is having different power centers.
Mm-hmm.
They do not apply this whatever agreement we have. We have a Shimla agreement,
mm-hmm.
According to Shimla agreement, the LOC and other international border, they have to respect that. So India is, after this speech of Mr. Modi from Red Fort, we have also, counter that through Baluchistan. And so I think China is also entering, Pakistan through CPEC and all. So we have, hit two targets with one stone, I think.
Sir, इससे पहले हमारी foreign policy approach थी that we will practice strategic restraint in our relation with Pakistan.
Mm-hmm.
But after Modi's proactive engagement with mm-hmm. other nations,
yeah.
India has mustered the will to strike back.
Yeah.
With the recently held these surgical strikes.
Yes.
In respect to Uri attacks.
We are so, pretty sir, active now on
yes.
this front. Yes.
Mm-hmm. देखो मोदी जी ने पहले तो दोस्ती का हाथ बढ़ाया. है ना जब उन्होंने शपथ ग्रहण किया तब भी उसके बाद भी ही स्टॉप्ड ओवर वाइल कमिंग फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान बट पाकिस्तान की प्रॉब्लम ये है कि जैसे मैंने बोला कि नवाज शरीफ चाहते हुए भी नहीं कर सकता एंड मे बी दिस राहिल शरीफ इज गोइंग आउट तो ही वांट्स टू बी ए सोल्जर की शुड बी रिमेम्बर्ड आफ्टर दिस उड़ी अटैक्स ही वांट्स टू हैव ए फुल फ्लेज्ड वॉर विद इंडिया in order to get some extension or some personal benefits.
Yes.
So we have to wait till November end. I think things will improve and Nawaz Sharif will have more say in Pakistan politics.
Always feel, sir, that democracy is never deep-rooted in Pakistan. Every time the elitists are the power centers,
yes.
The army is an elitist and similarly is the political class. So they come from abroad somewhere, UK, etc. वहाँ रहते हैं, election जीतते हैं, सरकार में आ जाते हैं, अभी जैसे नवाज शरीफ है तो उसी तरह से फिर उनको आर्मी वाले भगा रहते हैं वो रूल करना कर देते हैं शेड्यूल जैसे परवेज मुशर्रफ जी ने किया तो ये एक वहां पे ना शिफ्टिंग पावर सेंटर्स रहते हैं और वो एलीट के अंदर ज्यादा रहते हैं. डेमोक्रेसी या आम जनता पाकिस्तान की क्या चाहती है, उनसे कुछ खास लेना देना नहीं होता, और इसीलिए एक पॉलिटिकल सोवरेन के तौर पे किसी को भी डिसीजन लेना भी मुश्किल होता है.
नहीं, आपकी बात बिल्कुल ठीक है. मेरा ये भी मानना है कि कुछ हिडन हैंड भी है.
ओके.
ग्लोबल सेय वी हैव अ मोर यू नो वी हैव बिकम अ ग्लोबल प्लेयर नाउ फ्रॉम लास्ट ईयर एंड अदर देन दैट टेररिज्म यू नो इज अ इट इज नॉट ओनली अ थ्रेट टू इंडिया इट इज अ ग्लोबल थ्रेट एंड एज आई से यू नो अमेरिकन थिंकर सेज इट इज अ fight between a lion and a fly, mm-hmm. in which fly cannot give a knockout punch, mm-hmm. and lion cannot fly. Mm-hmm. So it is after this, you know, the lone wolf attacks and sleeper cell, it is not easy to identify a terrorist because he has suicide terrorism is a major challenge in 21st century.
So is this a failure of our policy in Kashmir? Ki hum abhi tak logo ka
No, it is a universal phenomena. You know, after 90s, if you see when there is power balance shifted in favor of America, these non-state violent actors, they have become, you know, powerful. Mm-hmm. You know, there is always a fight between the haves and have-nots. Mm-hmm. So it is not only in case of India, there mm-hmm. have been insurgencies and, you know, terrorist activities going on in other part of the world also.
True. For example, we have a Palestine-Israel issue. We have got ISIS issue right now. So it's like a post-World War II phenomena and post-Cold War phenomena. Now it's more regionalization of war, you know, in terms of soft attacks. Sometimes Islamic fundamentalism comes up. Sometimes some regional interests come up. And this way, the terrorism stays alive as a weapon or as an instrument of political sovereignty.
Yeah, but one thing I am sure, you know, if you see after the Russia, you know, intervened in Syria.
Yeah.
Now the you know ISIS they say is will become was mm-hmm. you know the situation is now you know in favor of you know the Russia mm-hmm. they have tried to control over this region, you know, they have given a tough fight to ISIS and all, and recently the city of Mosul and all, you know, there is Iraq army and all, you know, so you see if there is a balance of power, like two powers or a multi-power world emerging, definitely the terrorist or non-state violent actor will weak. They will be weakened, you know.
Okay.
That is my view.
Okay.
It is as global, you know, you can say threat, and there will be a global response also.
Okay.
So and that will affect even the insurgency and terrorism going on in India also.
True. So how should we conclude this answer, sir?
See, as far as I think so that after this, you know, cyber, they say this is the fifth domain of warfare.
Yes.
We just see the, you know, terrorist crossing LOC and all. Mm-hmm. Whereas the cyber terrorism is a major threat.
Okay, that should also be
answered. That should also be taken care of. Mm-hmm. And, you know, the main feature of that is ki there is no geographical limit.
Mm-hmm.
And it is very cheap, which suits the terrorists because they have limited resources.
Mm-hmm.
So that also we have to, you know, we have to fight on multiple fronts.
Okay. So I guess that future perspective must be taken into care from the cyber point of view also, and the limiting power of the non-state actors which is coming into play, right?
Plus, as far as the cross-border terrorism is concerned, we have to take some major steps to form border management, you know, good border management. And we are, I think from Israel, we are taking some laser walls equipment and other, you know, technical things to in order to check that threat.
Along with the social media.
Yeah. And media, you know, they say that media is an unintentional ally of terrorists.
Yes.
So we have to, you know,
so
it is a responsible, because media, you know, they have played a very vital role in our independence, Indian independence.
Mm-hmm.
So after this privatization, because of the TRP and all, media sometimes glorifies the terrorists, like Burhan Wani case.
Mm-hmm.
So media has to take a restraint, and, you know, they are also one of the major players. Which they can also eradicate, they can help in eradicating terrorism by not glorifying them.
Okay. So it's like border management, media management, maybe terrorist management, financial management, too many different dimensions of management which we covered. I think that should summarize the issue, and we will be taking up the series forward. Thank you so much.
Thank you.